Test 1-2. SEGA!
Two grumpy retro gamers. Last week you found us looking at Sega Saturn 1997 hit Die Hard Arcade starring John McClane. This week we're taking our trip back to our faithful 16-bit companion the Mega Drive, and we're going through the comic book pages and visiting Sketch Turner in Comic Zone. I'm Forbes London.
Mike Langebeer. That's right, today we're taking you to Comic Zone Mega Drive, only exclusive to the Mega Drive, Genesis and obviously the British version. Little insight on the story. He writes comics, weird lightning happens, bad guy comes out, his evil creation. He wants him dead, of course, because he's evil. Throws him in to this post-apocalyptic world that he's drawing. Bet he regrets it now. You know, bet he wishes he did something a bit more Disney, you know?
Yeah, absolutely. Wrote Lion King or Bambi or something like that instead. Yeah. So basically, main character, as we covered there in the beginning, Sketch Turner, apt, I suppose. And basically, this is a very unique game for the Mega Drive, being that it is probably the only game on the console that is based in a comic strip world.
Yeah.
So you have splits between the acts via pages, which you have to cross through. And that's where the action takes place when you have ripped through the page, much in the same vein that you have with a game like Streets of Rage, where it sort of filters the screen progressively. Comic Zone does exactly the same thing, requiring you to eliminate particular enemies before you can progress even further into the level. Now, this idea isn't the first time it was used for Comic Zone. You had Batman the Kid Crusader, which was released by Ocean Software, back in 1988, which used a very similar concept for the comic book style strip.
That's right, yeah.
It's not a unique idea, however it is probably the best executed idea up to point.
Oh, definitely, and it's such an unrated game as well.
I mean,
I remember at the time, I didn't even know about it. I think it was, 98, 99?
Yeah.
When we finally got it from the second-hand store. Maybe we bought it, played it, it was brilliant. I had so much fun on it, and I still do. I mean, I played a little bit a minute ago.
It's a fantastic game. It's aged particularly well, this title, due to its very cartoony style. And you'll find that a lot of cartoony games on various retro systems still play and look pretty fantastic today. Comic Zone perhaps is one of the hardest brawlers on the Mega Drive. It's very difficult to complete.
Yes, yeah, we never got around to completing that.
No.
I remember we got quite far, though.
No, we did, yeah. I believe there were two endings to the game.
That's right.
If I remember correctly. You had, I think, a good ending and a bad ending for the game. So it was quite a good approach there. And I think Streets of Rage 3 also had good and bad ending as well.
Well, the good thing about this one is, now and again, you get like a choice of where you would go. You know, you can either go to the next page, or you can go down the page. I think it even tells you, probably show you that anyway. We'll see it.
That's via manhole covers, isn't it?
Yeah, manhole covers. Yeah, you just get the different arrows, don't you?
Yeah.
So right, you can go that way, down that way. I like the choices.
Yeah.
I really do.
I do like the sort of dialogue between the enemies and the main character Sketch there, and also with, what's the baddie called?
Mortus,
something like that. Well, he's drawing in the characters.
Which I said to you before, like, yeah, he builds another one up, he draws another one. If you really want some dead, why don't you have a thousand of them?
Yeah.
Struggling with one? There's a thousand bad guys.
Absolutely.
Deal with that. I want you dead.
I don't know whether the Mega Drive processor would be able to deal with that. I mean, it's only 16 bits worth of information, so, no. You know, can't really do that.
But it is just a game.
That's all it is. It's not real. Right, so released in the August of 1995, I believe it's the beginning part, August 2nd, across the world, so NTSC territories and PAL territories as well. I think the game, as you said, is very underrated.
Yes.
Being quite late in the life cycle of 16-bit consoles, I think perhaps it was quite overlooked.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
I mean, to be honest, it's not brilliant graphics. But they get away with it because it's a comic book.
Yeah,
you know, it's simply drawn in, so definitely get away with it.
Is it comical?
It's comical.
Right. Do you fancy giving it a try?
Oh, I'd love to. Yeah, I really do. Yeah.
Right. Okay. Worth noting again is we've taken the six-button controller for
which
the Mega Drive. You do need it. I believe that various weaponry is assigned to the top three buttons in the Mega Drive controller.
Yeah.
So you can have your dagger, you can have dynamite, and your little rat, your little pet rat.
That. Eat through pages or something.
Rizzo,
yeah.
And eat through pages and stuff. Right, okay. So you've got a bit of rudimental story going on.
See, lightning.
Yeah.
Nope.
Grabbed him.
Oh.
Oh, come on, in you go. I'll swap places with you. Bloody dusty old fart. He's out.
You want to be free. You'll soon be dead. Can't cure you here. But your perfect place to do it is inside a comic. Isn't it evil? Night of the Mutants.
Yeah.
Sounds like a night out in Plymouth.
It certainly does, doesn't it? We've had many of those mutants. Okay, right, so he's dropped in, straight into the danger zone. Some men say he's on the highway to the danger zone. She's profanities.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Right, so I'll start it. That wasn't even me playing. That's new.
This one, eh? He's a card, isn't he? He's a card. Right, okay, nice little start up to the screen.
That's him, right in there.
Mm-hmm. Made by the SEGA Technical Institute. I believe that they, around that time, 94, 95, were creating quite a few Pico titles, which is the kids-based Mega Drive console that took the storybooks.
That's it. I mean, this one in particular, I mean, this is for all ages, isn't it?
Yes. Yeah, suitable for all ages, this game. So, yeah. As is this episode, profanity-free, safe for work.
What the? Must be the chosen one, yeah, it must be. Right, here's this dude.
Got your number,
straight in. I don't care.
Okay,
right. Be careful, they shoot out some stuff. You can't block it or anything. The only way you can do it is you jump over it, or... It's not having me, or just duck down.
Yeah, the characters on the game are quite keen on blocking, so it makes it very, very difficult versus something like Streets of Rage.
Draws in the end.
Yeah.
That's fine. Stops your little power now.
Yeah. Absolutely. Sometimes you can actually fight the enemies to the point where you blast them through the next page.
Yeah.
Which I think is a really good touch. Changing weather effects as well.
He's gone.
Bit like Escape from New York.
So you got a choice, straight down or right. I went down before, so I'm just going to go right now.
Seems like a logical. Got to watch yourself that barrel, because that explodes.
It does.
Mm-hmm.
I'm taking no chances.
No. He's giving it both barrels.
Somebody that just writes comics, he's you know, he's pretty fit.
Yeah. Well, he's a musician as well, apparently.
Oh, of course. Yeah. So, yeah, he must know all the...
He's a starving artist and he also is a musician. So, perhaps good with his hands. Drums?
Maybe.
Okay. Right, so here's Roadkill. Not Rizzo. Like that. Now, I can't remember quite... Oh, yeah, that's it.
Right, what do I want to do?
Well, you've got no choice, boy.
Nah. Do I want a knife?
No, probably not, because you've got a health potion. Actually, maybe use the health potion.
Yeah?
So,
I don't think there's a health potion.
It's where the six-button controller comes in very handy there. These three icons at the top of the screen here are assigned to the top three buttons on the six-button controller.
That's right.
Rather intuitively.
So these are blocking my way, and you get through there.
Something from Alien 3.
These are horrible little things.
They're really annoying. And can cause havoc with your play time on this game, that they can kill you very easily, especially if you get two, which we might see at some point.
These are horrible things as well.
Yeah.
Try to kick them off. If you see them underneath you, push down and kick them down.
I do kind of like the fact they say pack it in.
Yeah.
Pack it in.
Yeah, don't do that. I'm trying to,
yeah,
trying to kill you.
There you go.
Pack it in.
Pack it in. The animation's actually really good on this game. There's quite a lot of frames of animation which really show off the Mega Drive, as you'd expect from a late title. And this is very sort of reminiscent of Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The old Suicide, yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Right, we don't want to build that up because it's got a red thing in it.
Exclamation mark. Okay. Oh, oh, see, now you should have thrown it down there, boy.
Forgot about these.
Never mind. Right, this bit here is where you can fall foul, because the flying creatures can knock you straight off the edge. I believe we can knock him through the page, though.
I believe so, yeah.
Oh, there we go. Well, that's... There we go.
Yeah, he falls down.
Okay.
Nice.
Now we've got... There we go. There he is. This one will knock you straight off the side.
Yeah.
I don't know why he's... questioning you, calling you creep as well. Creep?
Maybe that's what he is.
Oh. A little creeper.
Right, I've got to be careful though. Last time I drop kicked him, I just fell straight down to my death.
Right, yeah. Can you do the, like, bicycle kick on him? Oh, no!
Did it again.
Oh!
Did it again.
There we go. Game over, man. The end.
Game over.
So basically, you'll see another, like, little cutscene that shows the bad guy of the game. You know, he's free to do what he wants to do. And he's become real.
Uh-oh. So
he's going to take over. Look, he's burnt the comic book.
Could have done that, didn't he?
Well, he could have, couldn't he? I don't understand. There you go, he's happy with it.
Yeah, yes. He's loving life. Rah!
Yes!
So dangerous. I mean, he just come back. You know, he's free in the world. He's standing on the edge. He's
yeah.
Little,
yeah, I love the blast of it. Got your overall superhero meter.
So you go.
Right, okay.
Love that bit.
Yeah. I think that's why we fondly remember this game.
Yeah, I think it is.
Okay, right. Okay. Let's pick up our various bits and pieces. A bit of cow pole, a dagger, and some dynamite. Okay, right. Okay, right, anyway, he's gone. You really have to try and use combinations of moves on the game, because if you keep living on the same move, it seems like the game almost picks up on the fact that you are doing that, and it will block. Going for a Mortal Kombat little small swipe on the floor there. Okay, got a couple of items in the foreground here as well, just to add to the immersion of the game. I'm going to go downwards rather than along there. So, apparently he loves the drums.
Love his drums.
Yeah, brilliant.
Little fist there.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. Used.
Missed that.
Right, okay.
Use the old dynamite then.
Yeah, actually it's a good shout.
Is that where you can pick the rat up?
Okay, that seems to work. Oh, obviously not. No, it is. Right. We'll use the potion instead. Right, the manhole up cover that you can kick down can be very difficult sometimes to see what's occurring there.
Yeah. I believe there's two here. Then you've got to fight.
I think you're right. Scanning life forms. Why is she not helping? Is what I want to know.
I don't know who she is.
Why is she in the comic? It's probably not a plot hole, but we probably just didn't read the blurb. Okay. Now, I believe the original concept for this game was on the Commodore Amiga, which we'll cover in a second once I've had a little playthrough and cleared my throat with it. Again, he's saying pack it in to me, but I'm not going to because he keeps attacking me. So what does he expect? Pack it in? Pack it in what? Okay.
Just one down there, I believe.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's just him.
Look at him. Right.
Yeah, come on.
Multiple ways to attack the enemies. Okay. Down he goes. No. Why is he saying, oh, my head for? Again, what do they expect? Any sympathy?
He's calling you a loser as well.
Yeah. I created him. Not me personally. He's actually quite tough, isn't he?
He is.
Not sure whether he can change difficulty on this game. He might very well be able to. Right, okay, let's try this a different way. Right. So, if we push that crate down there, should clear the area for us. Okay. Let's put you through there, shall we? Bit of slowdown for the Mega Drive there.
Did he take the other move in?
No.
Ah.
Oh.
It's closer to that.
See how easy it is to be dropped off the edge there?
I think you might be able to chuck a knife at him, actually.
I think you might be right. I think I'm getting him here.
Yeah, it is.
As you can see, it's very, very difficult to get past that particular part of the level. We're only human. Okay. Right, as we covered, basically the original concept for this game was on the Commodore Amiga, and it was called Joe Pencil Trapped in the Comix Zone.
That's right.
Which was created by Peter Morawiec, and he is actually the designer and writer of Comix Zone.
Oh, cool.
So working with the SEGA Technical Institute back in the day. The game was rated quite highly when it was first released. I think it got a 30 out of 40 from Famitsu, which they're notoriously hard to please.
Yeah.
So it did well. Other, I think slightly more critical with Western reviewers, saying that the honeymoon period can be, you know, easily got over with this game. That once you do start to go the various different routes and die multiple times on that first level, that it can start to wear a little bit thin.
Yeah.
Which I can sort of understand, but
I don't play that.
Yeah, I have played this game. You know, you get a snow level which comes afterwards, I'm pretty sure, and then I believe you get to the sort of final showdown where I think the woman ends up in, you know, peril.
Yeah.
And you've got a set time to save her, or you get a bad ending. So another thing with this game is that the North American release and I think limited edition PAL versions came with a music CD.
That's right, yeah. I did look this up.
Right.
You can actually still buy them.
Oh, really?
Game with the CD, and it's a little bit higher price than just the normal version.
Right.
So if you ever get a hands on one of those, get it, you know?
Okay.
I mean, CD's sure not bad. I mean, music's pretty techno, isn't it?
Yeah, it is a little bit, yeah, isn't it?
I'll enjoy that.
The soundtrack was actually released separately from the limited edition release of the game as well in August 96, under the Sega Tunes label, which Sega would pick some of the cool duds from their games and release them on CD for your viewing pleasure, listening pleasure, really, rather than viewing pleasure.
Yeah.
Hang the phone up on that one. yeah, so as we've said, uses the six button pad fully.
Yep.
So, well worth
it. Definitely need that six button pad for this.
Yeah. If you've got a late Mega Drive, chances are you'll probably have a six button pad.
Yeah.
But the game itself, you can always tell a late release Mega Drive game naturally because of the blue on the cover art here, but also very, very late games also come with just the black manuals, which is quite imperative if you are going to buy a copy of this game, you do have the booklet, because you don't want this sort of case with no booklet in it, just feels ultra light, and these are the cool cases to hold the manuals in perfectly.
That's right, yeah. You need a good amount of balance on that.
Yeah, absolutely. Mm. Power to weight ratio.
Yeah.
With Mega Drive games. I think, was this game on any other formats?
It came out on Xbox Live, didn't it?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, as far as
my knowledge went, though.
Right, okay, came out on Xbox Live, came out on the PlayStation Network as well. You can also find it on the virtual console for the original Wii. And there was also Windows versions of it.
Oh, right.
On Steam as well. And there's a Game Boy Advance port.
That's cool.
Came out in 2002.
That's cool.
Yeah. So that was developed when Sega were potless. So they were basically looking to make a quick buck. The GBA being the closest architecture to the 16-bit consoles from that day, Comix Zone found its way on to the Game Boy Advance. Along with other Sega franchises, which were Choo Choo Rocket, Jet Set Radio, Crazy Taxi.
Yeah.
I like to mention Crazy Taxi. I love Crazy Taxi.
Next one?
Maybe. So, So it came out on a magnitude of different formats as the years went on, which shows that the game is actually still appreciated and loved by a small group of people. You might not have heard of it, because a lot of the games that we have covered so far, many people haven't actually heard of, apart from Resident Evil on the GameCube.
Well, of course, yeah.
You know, a lot of people haven't played some of the other games. So we like to go with enlightenment on Two Grumpy Retro Gamers and bring to you games you might not have heard of that are well worth a try. This is certainly
I feel we keep going through games that we really like. Apart from Resident Evil, I think. But other games, we really like them, don't we?
We do.
Yeah.
Yeah, we do. We just like games. Like games in general.
It's true.
Some we hate.
Yeah. I don't think we should cover them, to explain why we hate them so much and why.
Yeah. We will get more grumpy and cover games we absolutely hate at some point. Not yet. Because, we're having fun. But what sort of value have we got on the game?
Well, this is where I'll come into it. Normal price game, you're looking for about £25.
Yeah.
With the CD though, £60.
60 quid with the CD?
Yeah.
That's a whole lot of bunts.
Mm-hmm. That's right. Genesis version is £30.
Okay, so that's quite expensive as well, because you would expect in North America it would sell far better than Pan territories.
Yeah. I think because it did advertise so well. I mean, I didn't even hear of it. I mean, I was a big Mega Drive fan at the time. There probably wasn't many copies going.
It's one.
It was junk.
It's quite common. It's old, it's quite common on eBay. You can find a copy any given Thursday.
I've seen a few copies on there, definitely.
Yeah. But they are gaining good money now because the game is actually starting to get a little more cred as the years go on, as being a very playable Mega Drive game, which some Mega Drive games don't age so well. This one's actually aged quite well, but it is brutally hard. So difficult. So if you do get it, stick with it, because it is a very rewarding game. And it's
like any game, really. You find it hard, you keep playing, and you get better. Do it with this.
Just get better at it.
But if you just want a quick game, just want to grab that one, quick play, unbox, £25.
£25 out of the box?
Mm.
Is it really?
Is it? Yes.
That's a lot of bunts.
Well, unless you find it with, like, your car boot sale.
For a couple of quid.
You know, son's gone off to uni, I'm clearing out the attic, I was excellent. Mega Drive games.
Sexy housewife selling off Mega Drive cartridges. She don't know what she's talking
exactly.
about.
Exactly. Oh, quid. Yeah. Oh, are you sure? Can't take it down? No. Oh, quid it is then.
Not 50p then, no? Oh, I'm trying to learn a little too much. Because we get all the retro vultures looking through retro games. Basically, when someone else picks up a find at the cupboard, he said, where did you get that from? Let me have a look at it.
Last thing you want to say. Go, oh, I remember then. Guess I could play them again. I'm actually looking for £10 a bit much for all of those games and consoles.
Yeah, I must admit, when I go to Cubby Sales and I ask how much a game is, and they're like 10. I'm like, pounds? I'm not paying £10 for it. I'll just walk off. Mm. I mean, they without fail sell for more on eBay. Well, sell on eBay then.
Yeah.
God's sake, don't waste my time because I'm here for bargains.
Yeah, sell more on eBay. Why are you down here then? Yeah. Stay at home.
That's it. Don't be trying to flog your wares out of the back of the car, bloody highway robbery.
Yeah.
All right. I'm not interested in it.
Go compare.
Yeah. Not interested in lying in your pockets.
Well, on eBay, it's more about eBay then.
Absolutely. So, with the values of the games, graphically, I put this game probably still at a 7 out of 10.
Really?
Yeah. Where would you put it?
Well, obviously, you can tell it's not good graphics. You can't see his face, really.
No.
Background's just still. But the thing is, like I said, you get away with it because it's a comic book.
Yeah.
You know? So it's such a clever idea. I might go for about 7 out of 10.
Okay.
Just for the fact that it is a comic book.
Dual sevens.
Hmm.
Lucky sevens. Audio. I think purely for the test 1-2 Sega bit at the beginning.
10 out of 10?
Gets a 10 out of 10.
Yeah, definitely.
Absolutely. Yeah, it never gets old with that. Playability, I'm probably going to give this a 6 out of 10 because of how difficult it is.
But it's still fun. I'm going to stick to 7.
7?
7 out of 10.
Okay. Overall, my rating is 7 out of 10 for the whole game. I think that's fair. What about yourself?
Yeah, same.
7? Lucky 7th again.
Yeah.
Okay, so that concludes our look at Comix Zone, our chosen choice of this week. Flavoursome little cut from the Mega Drive's library. And this is the part of the show where we like to do a shout out to our friends. I'd like to start perhaps with the one and only Mikey Hay, our favourite vlogger on YouTube. It's worth checking out Mikey's vlog. You can find it on YouTube. Just search for it. Alright.
Why not?
You know.
What else are you going to search for?
Yeah. Look on the bright side, alright?
You search for this.
Yeah.
Come this far. Go for Mikey Hay.
Found us. He's way better than us. John Robson, I'd like to do a shout out to John. You know, I'd like to feature him on later episodes.
Yeah.
Getting him in to play some of the more complex games while we just chat, like chatterboxes.
We'll set up a meeting.
Yeah.
Well, we'll have a drink down the pub.
Yeah, definitely. Like partial to a drink or two. I think probably worth mentioning a few retailers around the southwest that are worth checking out for retro games.
Once.
Got Once, which branches in St. Austell, Exeter, and Plymouth. I think also nerds.co.uk, they've got an outlet in Plymouth, and they also have their website, aforementioned.
Oh dear.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know the one, can't remember.
Tech Outlet?
Tech Outlet, that's the one.
My friend Aaron over at the Tech Outlet. Also got various other places that you can buy retro software that isn't eBay.
Mm-hmm.
You've got Console Passion, Retro Goods.
Yeah.
If
you listen to this, get your retro games out, because I want to have a look, see if we can get some games for this, really.
Yeah, absolutely. And if you want to send us free samples of retro games, that would be absolutely swell. Probably don't need them because we have thousands, but...
If anybody has a Jaguar that would like to hand to us, please do.
That would be swell.
With games?
Yes.
And power leads?
Yeah. And controllers?
And controllers.
And free post? Yeah?
Yeah.
So
first class.
First post that hurts the most.
Yeah.
So, yeah. We'd be quite happy to cover consoles at a later date, and if anyone is willing to loan us hardware, then we'll promise we'll look after it and won't spill any of our Jesus juice on it.
Jesus juice.
Jesus juice.
I'll speak. Sorry.
Okay, one last shout out is to the Sega Megadrive hardware. We shout out to the Saturn last week for not letting us down, and the Megadrive is in the same boat.
Second time now. Yeah. It's a cute little machine here.
A little cow pat.
The cow pat itself.
Mm-hmm. We've really enjoyed sort of covering Mega Drive software, haven't we?
Oh, we really have.
Yeah, the real tangible flavour.
We can just carry on doing it. We even thought of a game. We thought, oh, we can't do that. We just did the Mega Drive games.
Yeah. So basically, we just thought, Comix Zone, let's do it.
Yeah.
Mm. Yeah, so I think the next episode, we promise we will move on to some new hardware. Rather than covering...
Well, we won't go that new. What should we see, the old PlayStation 2.
Yeah, I think we should probably visit Sony's hardware.
Yeah, they've been in a bit of a shadows at the moment. So yeah, we should definitely do that.
Certainly don't want to come across as Sega and Nintendo fanboys, do we? So that's fine. Right, so I've been Comical Force London for this episode.
You know who I am.
You know his face.
You know
what
you know me.
And we'll see you next game.
See ya.